Here we have a box with an interesting looking lip. The lip itself is planar, but the step surrounding it is non-planar. If I highlight the top face of the step, you can see that it traverses each of the four faces of the box in a different way. Let's see how this can be done. We will begin with a regular cuboid. The key to building this lip feature is to sketch out the path of the lip on each of the four faces. Instead of opening up a sketch on each of these four faces, we shall create a single 3D sketch. Let's start a sketch on this face. Go to the sketch palette and check the 3D sketch option. Start creating the profile on this face. Using the line tool, snap one end of the line to this edge and the other end to the opposite edge. You will know that the line has snapped when you see a cross. Turn the cuboid. Begin the next line by snapping to the end point of the previous line. This time, when you snap, you will see a square. As you hover the cursor over this face, Fusion recognizes that you are trying to sketch on this face and will lay down the sketch entities accordingly. You can tell by the face being highlighted in a slightly darker shade. Continue to do this for the other two faces. We have now created a 3D contour. The next step is to create a surface using this. Before that, in order to achieve a surface with a better quality, I would recommend to use these sketches to create root faces as guiding faces. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Root. Uncheck the Chain Selection option. We will need to create the root surfaces individually with each segment. Select one of the segments as a profile. Select Direction for Type. Click on the Select box for Direction, and select this plane. We want the surface to be normal to this plane. Drag the surface out slightly. Repeat this for the other four segments. Hide the 3D sketch. Go to Create, Patch. At this point, if you hover the cursor over a surface, you can see the boundary of the surface being highlighted. To prevent that, we need to uncheck the chaining option. Start selecting the inside edges. For continuity, select Tangent for all edges. If we had created a patch using only the sketch curves, we would not have this continuity option. Confirm the operation. Hide the root faces and unhide the solid cuboid. Go to Modify, Flip Body. For body to split, select the cuboid. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the newly created patch surface. You should now see two solid bodies. Hide the body that we do not need and also hide the patch surface. Let's add in the fillets at the four corners. It is important to create fillets before the shell so that we do not run into inconsistent thickness issues at the corner. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Modify, Shell. Adjust the thickness accordingly. We now need to create a profile for the inner lip, which is essentially an offset from the edge. Let's create a sketch on the base of the box. Uncheck the 3D sketch option and click on Look At to look normal to the sketch plane. go to Modify, Offset, and select the outer edge of the box. Drag and adjust the distance. Now, we need to project the inside edges of the box. Press P for project and select the inside face. Hide the box for a better look. Confirm the sketch. This will form the profile for the inner lip. Pre-select this profile and begin the extrude command. Drag the extrude upwards. If we unhide the box at this point, Fusion would assume that you are trying to do a cut. Go to Operation and select Join, so that this extrude will merge into the existing body. Or if you want to create a lip that also follows the outer edge, we can actually make use of the previously created patch surface. Let's use the Move Copy command to create a copy of this face that is at a slight offset. Go to Modify, Move Copy. For Move Object, select Bodies and select the surface. For Move Type, select Translate and adjust the distance accordingly. Since we want to create a copy of this face, we need to check the Create Copy option. Go to Modify, Split Body. For body to split, select the box. For splitting tool, select the new surface. Hide the surfaces and the portion of the unwanted body.